Hello, chaps. Just finished off the last of the Vikings that have been on the workbench quite some time now, and I was quite pleased with these ones, I must admit. They're all gripped by gripping beast, all metal. You've got the sort out this camera. You've got this guy here, which I put on a 40mm square base. He's the commander, or divisional commander in Hail Caesar. And you've got some leader types. This guy here, along with his three other mates, are berserkers. And you've got a musician there for one of my units, which is lacking.
Lovely figures to paint up.
And I'm very happy the way they've turned out. All the shields have been hand painted, not too fancy. No, and I enjoyed painting that a little lot. This guy here, this chap.
I think it's my favourite pose. I'm getting going the right way.
Pose is simplicity itself, really, isn't it? It's just a little bit of movement of the upper body, and you end up with one like that. So that's the guy there. I gave him a plastic Danax from the plastic figure range and a metal javelin. So matey boy.
A bit too close.
That's better. So there's those, which we packed away now in the boxes. Let's get those out of the way. If you just bear with me just 1 second, I've finished the first unit of Norman Spearman, which I've been labouring on. So this is a unit of 24, six bases of four. So that's two, three, that's the command stand. These are Black Tree design. Nice and easy to paint. Good looking figures. And this is the unit that suffered from the varnish debacle. But the basing just given that little bit of a lift, so hopefully not too noticeable. I kept with the blue and red shields and a few of the helmets. Which is a theme I'll keep on throughout the army.
All right, chaps.
That's the latest update.